Hello everyone, my name is Jing, and today I'm going to talk to you about dalgona coffee. Dalgona coffee is basically whipped coffee sitting on top of milk. So you may know that the coffee trend started in Korea, but dalgona coffee is really much more international than you think. Dalgona coffee originated in India, where it's known as beaten coffee or sometimes Indian cappuccino. So how did this coffee even end up in Korea? The story has it that in January, a Korean actor came across this drink in Macau while hosting a variety show. When he tried the drink, he said it tasted like a Korean hard candy snack, which gave the drink its name, dalgona. But the trend really took off in March when countries came under lockdown to curb the spread of COVID-19. Because the ingredients are so easy to find and because the final product is just so photogenic, many people started making their own versions of the drink and sharing photos of it on Instagram. So talking about making the best out of the situation, dalgona coffee is an iconic symbol of that. The magic part of dalgona coffee has to be the soft, foamy whipped coffee layer on top. So the classic whipped coffee recipe calls for instant coffee, sugar, and water mixed in a 1:1:1 volumetric ratio, and then whipped together until you get soft peaks. But as a long-time, relatively health-conscious coffee drinker, this is where the problem gets a little bit personal. So firstly, 1 tablespoon of sugar in 1 cup of coffee is, well, really a lot of sugar. So must I get you sugar to get my beautiful, stable, whipped coffee layer on top? And why must it be instant coffee? Can I use any other kind of coffee? So to answer these 2 questions, I posed my challenge to, well, let's just call him the barista, shall we? I posed my challenge to the barista to recreate the drink. Yes, the barista says hi. So he's going to create the dalgona coffee using, firstly, anything other than instant coffee, and secondly, anything other than sugar. So it's just like doing an experiment, isn't it? You have something you want to try out, you try it, but just as with any good experiment, we will create the original dalgona coffee using the most common recipe. So this most common recipe calls for a volumetric ratio of instant coffee to water to sugar 1:1:1. So it's going to use 1 tablespoon of coffee, 1 tablespoon of water, and 1 tablespoon of sugar. So just to note that volumetric equivalent ratio doesn't mean that we are adding the same mass of each compound of each item into the mixture. So let's say, for example, if you see 1 tablespoon of ground coffee or 1 tablespoon of instant coffee, it's usually a lot lighter than 1 tablespoon of sugar. So you can get something like maybe say 8 grams of coffee versus 16 grams of sugar, that kind of ratio. So let's just wait for him to mix everything together. So after he's done adding the 3 different ingredients together, what he's going to do is that he's going to use a whisk to whisk everything together. So that process incorporates air into the mixture. And it looks like he's ready to start mixing. Okay, dalgona coffee is kind of like, you know, a free arm workout when you're at home. So while he's busy whisking the coffee, let me just quickly walk you through the science behind whipping the coffee. Before I continue, I just want to sort of disclaimer that no one has actually come up with a proper study on how the whipped coffee actually works. If you have an alternative explanation as to how the foaming actually works, let us know in the comments below or private message us in any of our social media channels, which I'll link at the end of this video. So, right, to the science. Now, I just want you to sit back and think about this concept. Coffee oil. Yes, not kidding you. If you take a cup of coffee, you stick it in the centrifuge, and you let it spin very, very fast for a very, very long time, what you get is a layer of coffee oil on top, which is basically a mix of many different kinds of lipid compounds. So some of these you can also find in other kinds of plant oil, but some of these are unique to coffee itself. But for the sake of understanding the foam, yes, I think you can see a lot of compounds here. You don't need to know every single molecule. What you need to know is that each molecule can be simplified into this form. A lipid molecule typically has a hydrophilic head, meaning a part that likes water, and a hydrophobic tail, which is a part that doesn't like water. So for such compounds with very distinct hydrophilic and hydrophobic regions, we call it amphiphilic. And that is a very interesting property that fats actually have. These coffee oils are what we call surfactants, or surface acting agents. So what they actually do is that they lower the surface tension of the water. One interesting thing about them, when you add coffee oil to water, these molecules form something called micelles. Yeah, this little funky globule look-alike thing that you see right here. So imagine the surfactants banding together to protect their little hydrophobic tails by coming together and creating a sphere to prevent the tails from actually sticking out into the water. And the hydrophilic head will be facing towards the water because hydrophilic means they like water. So when you make coffee on a regular basis, you don't actually see these little micelles forming. I mean, you cannot see them with a naked eye. But what happens when you agitate the coffee water mixture? So when you introduce a lot of air to the mixture, two things can happen. Firstly, the coffee oils help to reduce the surface tension of the water so it becomes easier to foam up. And secondly, the micelles prevent the bubbles from sticking together to form one big bubble and then burst. So the end result you have is a stable foam. Coffee oil is also the reason for why you see a layer of crema on espresso. The next time you go buy espresso at Starbucks, you can go take a look. Because when you pull an espresso shot, what you're actually doing is that you're adding hot water to coffee grounds at very high pressure. So crema is actually a mix of coffee oil, water, and carbon dioxide that is present in the coffee grounds. Here's the catch. Foaming is one thing. Making the foam stable is another thing. So this is where sugar enters the picture. Micelles don't form spontaneously. It requires the right amount of water concentration or the critical micelle complex, CMC, in order to form. So to stabilize the micelles, we use what we call hygroscopic compounds. Hygroscopic compounds, in simple terms, are basically compounds that attract water from its surroundings. In the case of whipped coffee, there are two different kinds. One is melanoidins, which are a product of the Maillard reaction. I hope I got that right. Maillard reaction that happens when you roast coffee beans. I mean, Maillard reaction is like the most delicious chemical reaction ever. Maybe next time I'll do a video on that. The other one is, well, sugar. These two compounds attract the water, make it easier for the mixture to reach its CMC, and then micelles can form, leading to a more stable foam. Okay, I think the barista is done whisking, like, finally. How's your arm doing? I think his arm is doing fine. So let's see how it works. Oh, look at that. Yeah, now it's like creamy and nice. Looks like the recipe really works. The whipped coffee layer is less dense than milk, so it'll form a very nice layer of coffee on top. Oh yeah, one thing I have to tell you about Dalgona coffee is that there is really a lot of coffee for that small amount of coffee foam. Because if you think about it, one tablespoon instant coffee is really a lot of coffee. So as much as the drink is nice, it's actually very potent as well. So be careful not to take too much of it. If not, you can't sleep at night. Yeah, and there you have it. Your conventional Dalgona coffee. So how is it? Looks like the barista likes it. Yeah! Okay, so now that the barista has his dose of coffee, let's answer the first question. Can I use something other than instant coffee? Well, I mean, instant coffee is quick and easy, but it does lack in flavor and taste. If you've drunk coffee for long enough, you probably know that. So can we use something like espresso to make the whipped coffee instead? So later on, if you take a look, the barista has actually chosen a darker roast or espresso. Why is that so? Well, many recipes online will probably tell you that espresso doesn't actually work. Because, surprisingly, espresso has is much more dilute than normal instant coffee. Because, as I mentioned to you, if you mix 1 tablespoon of instant coffee with 1 tablespoon of water, what you get is something that is really very, very concentrated. I mean, day to day, if you use instant coffee to make coffee, you probably just use a teaspoon or two of it. And a tablespoon is very easily a few times of that. And to mix that into 1 tablespoon of water is really a lot of coffee. So that is why, in comparison, espresso is actually more dilute. So he's going to choose a darker roast simply because we want to improve the chances of us getting a nice coffee foam. Darker roast coffee means potentially that the coffee has more melanoidins in it. Darker roast generally means that the coffee is being roasted for a longer period of time, which means possibly higher amounts of melanoidins. If you remember what I told you just now, melanoidins are hygroscopic, which means they attract water and they act as stabilizing agents in the coffee foam. So the higher the concentration, the more the likelihood of getting a nice foam. So let him extract the espresso first. That looks really nice. The barista looks very impressed. Okay, because he has added espresso this time, which is essentially coffee and water, he's not going to add any more coffee or any more water. He's just going to add sugar straight away. Is it working? Okay, looks like the barista has given up. Instant coffee, because we need them to be stored for a longer period of time, usually they have more stabilizers within the compound itself as compared to espresso, which you usually drink once you extracted it. So that is why espresso is not a good option for dalgona coffee in terms of forming the coffee up. So don't try this at home unless you really, really want a very intense arm workout. Okay, so on to question number 2. Can I use something other than sugar? So as I mentioned to you, sugar acts like a stabilizing compound by being hygroscopic and attracting the water content inside the coffee. But 1 tablespoon of sugar is really a lot of sugar. I mean, the coffee foam is really tempting, but thinking of the white sugar in there, well, I mean, are there any other alternatives? So Mr. Barista, do you have any alternatives for us? No, that's what I'm talking about. I mean, okay, brown sugar will work just fine, but nah, that's not really what I'm looking for today. Maybe I should do a video on different kinds of sugars in the future. So Mr. Barista, do you have something else for us to try? Ah, that's what I'm talking about. Yes, honey. That looks more like it. So it is a bit arguable as to whether honey or sugar has more calories for the same volume. But honey has a whole bunch of health benefits as compared to sugar. So watch as he mixes the coffee with the honey. Okay, he has gone back to instant coffee, which is really smart. Oh wow, look at that! Yes, it's as per the original recipe! So as shown here, honey works as well, simply because honey contains sugars as well, and sugars are hygroscopic. So this actually serves the exact same function as per what white sugar would do. But one note of caution if you're using honey, because honey does have water in it as well, you may need to adjust the volume a little bit. If not, the final product may be a bit more watery than what you like it to be. So watch as our barista prepares the final drink for us. So there you have it. A guilt-free dalgona coffee. Now I think he needs to find a Grab delivery driver to get that to me. Yeah. Okay, so there you have it. Our questions answered for making dalgona coffee. Special thanks to the barista for helping us in this video. And to those watching at home, now that you all know how dalgona coffee actually works, you can try out different ways of making the coffee foam. And while you sip on a dalgona coffee, why not check out our Facebook page right here. And if you haven't followed our Instagrams, find us right here at SayYesSCS. If you decide to make your own versions of dalgona coffee as well, feel free to tag us in your own photos. Thank you for watching this video. Stay home, stay safe, and we will see you really soon.